Yesterday morning, we left our Monument Valley area campground and we drove about 2 hours to our current location. So stay tuned for the second half of our trip of Mesa Verde National Park and then the remaining stops on the return home. We've had several people ask us, what do we cook while we're on the road? One of our favorite things to cook is crockpot lasagna. It's quick and it's easy and it's very good for the road. I will show you how we do that. First thing you got to do is brown the hamburger. We've done that either the day that we're cooking it or we've cooked it the evening before and put it in the refrigerator. Just depends on how quickly you want to be able to put it together when you get to your location. The recipe requires 1 pound of hamburger. The other ingredients it needs is lasagna noodles, ricotta cheese, mozzarella cheese, and a jar of sauce. You'll need one large jar. We've done this recipe in both the square slow cooker as well as the standard round slow cooker, so either one works. The first step you do is you put 1 cup of the sauce to coat the bottom of the crock pot. The remainder of the sauce will be mixed with the hamburger. Then you put 1 layer of the uncooked lasagna noodles in the crock pot. Then after you do that, you put 1/3 of the meat and you spread that around. And then after you put your meat mixture, you do 1/2 of your ricotta cheese. So that goes on here. And again, you just spread it out then so it's uniform throughout the crock pot. And then once you have your first layer of ricotta on, you put a slight layer of mozzarella cheese. And then you start the process again over again. You put 1 layer of noodles, another bit of the meat, and then the other 1/2 of the ricotta. All right, so we have our new layer of noodles. We have our next bunch of meat. All right, then we put the rest of the ricotta cheese, so everything that's left. And then you'll put another layer of noodles, another layer of the meat, and then you top it off with mozzarella cheese. Let me come back when I have it all together. Once you have all the ingredients, you cook it on low for 4 hours, and then it's ready to eat. Well, that's the quick prep for our crock pot lasagna. I've actually cooked this while the camper's in motion when the meat has been pre-cooked. I just put it together and then run it on our normal outlet, and then it's ready to eat when we get to the campgrounds. I'll show you later once it looks like when it's all ready to eat. Here is the finished lasagna. And for additional flavor, you could add sausage or pepperoni. Today we toured Mesa Verde National Park. Included in that, we took a ranger guided tour of one of the ancient Pueblo dwellings, the Cliff Palace. This was a fantastic tour, lots of information, and this is one of the neatest places we've ever been to. You do have to reserve the tickets for the tour online, and it's $8 a person, and they do go very quickly once they're released for your particular date, so make sure you plan accordingly. But overall, very nice park, different from a lot of the other national parks in that there's not wildlife and things like that. It's definitely just a historical. This is the highest point in Mesa Verde National Park at 8,572 feet. You can see the whole valley and then the mountains there in the distance. those are the Rocky Mountains. This park is right at the end. This is the Oak Tree House. This set of ruins is the Cliff Palace. And this is the one that we are going to tour. It's the second largest of the dwellings. This morning, we're going on a tour of the Cliff Palace ancient dwellings at Mesa Verde National Park. After walking down a series of unlevel steps made of rock, now we're climbing the first of our four ladders.
Euro-American descent, they named it Cliff Palace. But we believe today this is a village. So inside of this village, there are 150 rooms. Probably about 100 to 120 people lived in this village. So 3 to 4 times as many people as we have in our whole group. Most of what you're seeing is all original. That's over 800 years old. Pretty amazing. So here, it's a mortar mostly made from mud. Sometimes they mix ash or clay or sand in with it, but for the most part, it's really just mud that has held these together so long. And they're still standing so well because they're protected by this alcove, which is natural. They didn't dig this out, this forms naturally, and then they found it and built inside of it. Sources close to them and be able to have defensible areas. That's a really just the cult. All the little openings are all doors. Then these little tiny ones are windows.
Then how do people get
there? People
were
much smaller back then. These are doors. Door. Window.
Kivas are gathering places. They're places for teaching, for learning, for worship, for social gatherings, lots of different stuff inside of these sites. And this kiva is missing something. All these kivas are missing something. Pretty important.
The people. What do you think? A roof?
and people for sure. Okay.
Again, all of these are doors.
The roof of the kiva is built on these pillars. They provide the foundation for the roof. You take beams and go. It's easy to think about times in the past like this and think how different it might be from our communities today. And look at other places in the world present day and say, that's so different.
Well, we just got done with our tour of the ancient Pueblo ruins in the Cliff Palace. It was a fantastic tour. I definitely recommend it for everyone. You have to reserve tickets online. It's $8 a person, but definitely worth every penny. It was fantastic. We're on a hike to see the balcony house since we didn't get a tour. Here's the balcony house. Here's another view of the balcony house. This one is smaller and it's also more buried in the cliffside. This is the spruce tree house. This is the most preserved of all of the dwellings here at Mesa Verde. It's the most intact. It's crazy to think that people live there. Now that we're back from the park, I thought I'd show you our campsite. We are staying at the ancient Cedars Mesa Verde RV Park. We are in site 610. This is a full hookup, and they call this premium pull through, which means they're a little bit larger, and you also get with the premium sites premium Wi-Fi, which is quicker than the other park Wi-Fi. Here is the electrical There's 20, 30, and 50 amp. And then the water and sewer. You also get a picnic table and a fire pit. All of the campsites at this campground are completely gravel. There's some trees, but very little grass. And all of the sites, even the premium ones, are pretty narrow, so you may have difficulty getting your slides fully out unless you center yourself correctly in the site. There's back-end sites as well. Campground was almost full last night, but a bunch of people have left today. This campground does have a pool and a hot tub. It's located up near the front of the park by the office. There's also a mini golf course and a few other amenities to enjoy. This site was $45 per night. And again, it did have some Wi-Fi that's pretty fast, so it's definitely usable. Well, that's our campsite here at Ancient Cedars Mesa Verde RV Park. This park is located literally 5 minutes from the entrance to the national park. So as far as location and convenience, it doesn't really get any better than that. And although this park doesn't have the concrete and is not quite as nice as some RV resorts, it's definitely worth the price that you pay. The internet is decent, and we would definitely stay here again. Unfortunately, our Western adventure is starting to come to an end, and we're heading back east. We left our Mesa Verde campsite this morning and drove to Albuquerque, New Mexico. We're gonna stay here one night, and we're gonna go this evening to up the Sandia Mountain Tramway. And then tomorrow we're gonna leave and head to Amarillo, Texas for another stop. Tonight we're staying at the Route 66 RV Park. It's east of Albuquerque in Edgewood, New Mexico. This is another full hookup campsite. It's fully gravel, however, it's very well packed gravel. This is a pretty nice site. There's a grill and then a plastic topped picnic table. There's also a nice fire pit and plastic all-weather Adirondack chairs. Behind the picnic table and the fire pit, they put these nice wood fences for privacy from your neighbor, because there aren't too many trees and there isn't really any privacy between the sites. It's pretty wide open. As you can see, this is a very wide campsite. Lots of room on the site. As you can see and probably hear, this campground is located right next to Interstate 40. You get off at an exit to access the entrance of the campground, but it's right near the highway. So it is a little bit loud, at least during the day while the traffic is heavy. We are in site 36. This site cost us $65, so definitely more on the pricey side compared to what we've been staying at recently and for what you get. Other than it being full hookup, there's really no amenities, but it is a really nice updated site. Thank you.
under us, or about the same elevation as the Empire State Building's observation deck, just over 1,000 feet.
This evening, we rode up the Sandia Peak on the tramway. This is the view from the top of the tramway. Here's the view of Albuquerque from 10,300 feet. The huge town looks tiny. So far down because it's so little looking. The cars come every 20 minutes or so. I feel it in my veins, masking all this pain, been searching high and low, with nowhere else to go. I used to feel alive, so many years went by, I wish I had more time, just wanna feel alright. Stars across the sky, guide me home, no more crying, it's time to go. So we're at our very last destination campground. I will give you a quick tour of the campsite and the campground. Very nice themed campground. Very nicely maintained. We are in site 11. This is a full hookup pull-through site. Fully gravel site, but it's very fine packed gravel, so actually really nice. And this section has lots of big rigs in it, so plenty of room for large RVs and those towing a vehicle. Nice little decorative electric pole. Here are the electrical outlets, and each site also gets a nice picnic table. Our site is only a short walk from the heated indoor pool, located right behind that propane tank. The pool at this campground is a heated indoor pool. There's a playground. There's also a bounce pillow. And again, just neat little theming items. If you don't have an RV, you can rent cabins. There's several different cabins. Here's a community area. Also, very unique to this RV park, you can actually stay in one of these wagons instead of a cabin or an RV. Have a few different ones. Very cool. And they're parked by these little buildings. Cool little themed area. Another community area for the cabins back here. Well, that's our campsite and some of the campground here at the Big Texan RV Ranch in Amarillo, Texas. This site was only $46 a night, so considering the amenities you get with the heated indoor pool, the children's areas, the shuttle to the steakhouse, and the hookups, it's definitely worth the $46 a night. We would definitely stay here again. While we're stopped in Amarillo, we drove over to the Cadillac Ranch. It's a quirky little spot where some Cadillacs are just stuck into the dirt. Everybody comes up to them, a lot of people spray paint on them, take photos. Just a quirky little spot. So we stopped in Amarillo, Texas, only to visit the Big Texan. It's a classic Route 66 area attraction. They have a free 72-ounce steak challenge. If you can eat the steak and all the side dishes in 1 hour, you can get it for free. In addition to the RV park, they also have a hotel that you can stay in. This one is right on the property. Got some cool theming. Here's everything you have to eat in the free steak challenge. And you get 1 hour to eat everything. A half order of fried mushrooms. Somebody's trying the 72-ounce steak challenge. I got baby back ribs, mac and cheese, and mashed potatoes. And I also got a honey blonde ale that's brewed right here at the restaurant. Well, good morning. We spent our last night of this vacation on the road. We left Amarillo, Texas yesterday morning, and we had a long 11-hour driving day. We stopped last night at the RV South Park in Sullivan, Missouri. This is a fully automated RV park. You book everything online. Your site is automatically ready at the time that you tell it you're going to arrive. And it is a nice, quick, overnight, full hookup site. All the sites are exactly the same. They're long and they're paved. Once you book the site, it sends you an email with a link on how to operate everything. But basically you, for to use the electrical, you turn the main to whether you want 50 amp or 30 amp, and then you plug in. If you want to use the sewer, you hold that button and slide up that arm, and then the water is self-explanatory over there. With taxes and everything, this site ended up being around $55. It's a little bit expensive for what you get, but it is a quick, convenient, really nice quality full hookup site. I did forget to mention it also has free Wi-Fi. It's located on a service road right next to Interstate 44. So it's definitely a convenient on and off for an overnight stop. They also have a dog park for to exercise your dog. They're supposed to be building several more of these throughout the country, so be on the lookout for them. Well, as our vacation winds down, we have one last driving day today. It's going to be about 9 hours before we reach home, so we're going to get started.